attack? No. Not attack them. Wipe the slate clean. Make the Mojave like it was meant to be. Undisturbed by man. I'll send the cloud, the holograms, bring ruin in my hands until only I stand atop the Helios One Tower again. I'll scour the gam with the cloud, rain its walls with spears from the sun, with an army of old world ghosts behind me, holograms all. I'll kill them until it's only me. Me, alone. In a quiet world. In a world that's nothing like what happened at Helios One. I've read your Pip-Boy, seen what you've done. If you wish to end them, I could use someone like you. Resourceful, uncompromising. NCR has many soldiers, many citizens. Perhaps I was too quick to put a collar on a potential ally. Very well. I'll come down and show you what the Sierra Madre has in store.
In the years that followed, the legend of the Sierra Madre faded, and there were no new visitors to the city. Years later, when a mysterious blood-red cloud began to roll across the Mojave, then west toward the Republic, no one knew where it had come from. Only that it brought death in its wake. Attempts to find the source of the toxic cloud failed. The Mojave was cut off. Through the cloud, lights were seen from Helios One. There were stories of ghosts immune to gunfire who struck down anyone they saw with rays of light. The last chapter of the Mojave came when a modified Repcon rocket struck Hoover Dam, releasing a blood-red cloud, killing all stationed there. All attempts to penetrate the cloud and retake the dam failed, and both the NCR and Legion finally turned away from it, citing the place as cursed. Eventually, the last vestiges of NCR faded from the Mojave in the west, wiping the slate clean. Only two remained alive in the depths of the cloud at the Sierra Madre, waiting for their new world to begin again.
You dirty coward. The bosses of the Omergas? The Omernas? The ones that run Gamora. Someone killed them.
You're making me carry the heavy stuff, aren't you?
Thank you.